And this is Scott Workman. This is video 9 in a series of who the hell knows how many. Again, Sandra Harrison from the Allglades County Humane Society has overdone it. She's actually charged me with, and I'm going to quote it off the warrant here, aggravated menacing. According to Sandra Harrison, that I have threatened her and I have been charged with aggravated menacing now. The latest update on what's going on with the dog situation is we went to the Salina Animal Hospital where the vet checked over my dog Gizmo, then gave him a rabies shot and brought him up to date on the other shots that he needed. After he was there and he was had a physical by the vet, they determined that he is 5 to 7 years old, so Sandy Harrison's claim that my dog is only 2 years old is out the window. Now back to this thing. Aggravated menacing is the charge. Today there was a warrant issued for my arrest, and it states that I am to have no contact with Sandra Harrison. Sandy, I don't know what it is you're trying to pull, but you should keep in mind malicious prosecution. In order to charge somebody with aggravated menacing, you had to actually sign a statement and you had to make claims that are going to be a lie. If you're claiming that I threatened you in any way, shape, or form, there were 15 people there, at least 15 people. There were vets, there were vet techs, there was the newspaper guy, there was attorneys, and of course us present. So if you're going to say that I threatened you there, you should probably try to get a bunch of people to lie for you instead of just you lying, because everyone there heard exactly what I said to you. I actually said, I don't like you. Actually, I said you were a pretty mean person. I said, in my opinion, you were useless. I said a whole bunch of stuff because I don't hide the fact I don't like you. But you got to not read into that as a threat. You can't make up lies and go file a police report. So I'd like for you to know that I've not been placed in handcuffs. I wasn't arrested. I wasn't placed in a jail cell. None of that happened. So if that's what you were looking for, it didn't happen. I simply paid $225, and actually, I never even went to the jail. Somebody else went up and paid it for me, so I never even seen the jail. So if you were looking for something for me to do, maybe me to be in jail, be in the back of the police car, none of that happened, so it didn't work out for you. What I would suggest is that you contact counsel and you ask them about this malicious prosecution and what you're possibly going to be liable for. We have a court date set for, let me see here, October the 13th at 9 a.m. to answer to these charges of aggravated menacing. So you and whoever else that you choose to bring will be at court. Anyone who would like to see this hearing, I know that there will be many counsel there. There will be newspaper and possibly even TV persons there to watch the outcome of this. And like I said, I think you should probably look into things before you go out lying. What was that, a month ago or so that we were at the vet, and you're just now saying that you're in fear for your life? Just so we're clear here, I'm beginning to wonder what all this is about. I mean, there must be even more there, because so far, Sandy Harrison of the Humane Society has kept my dog, refused to return it, lied about the age of my dog, said it was 2 years old, testified under oath in court she doesn't know where my dog is, testified in front of a stenographer under oath that she doesn't know where my dog is, that Amanda Faust has my dog. She's also been found to be buying dogs from other humane societies or other dog wardens and then selling them for a profit at her own shelter. She's also been found to now tell Walpock, the city of Walpock, she no longer needs their money to house dogs and that she will no longer take in animals from Wapakoneta. And now she is saying that I am menacing her, when menacing means that you are in fear or I have threatened you in some way. Make no mistake, the fact that I don't like you doesn't mean I'm threatening you. And it's to the point now where I'm wondering about the mental stability of Sandy Harrison. I'm wondering what's going on there and should somebody possibly step in and try to assess what's going on here. Because now it's went past the fact that she has my dog, won't return it, was buying and selling dogs, or maybe still is, has turned down money now from Wapakoneta, and says she will not take any dogs in. You're in Wapakoneta. How can you not take dogs in from Wapakoneta? That is just absurd. And now that you found out that the vet has said, in fact, that my dog that was had a physical at the facility is not 2 years old like you testified under oath and like you stated, and that he's in fact 5 to 7 years old, now you've pushed it to aggravated menacing. So, in my opinion, I think that someone should look into this, family members, relatives. Someone needs to address what's going on here, how you can be doing all these individual things and it not add up to something's not right. I don't know what it is exactly. It's got to be more than you just simply want to keep my dog. I don't know what it is. I've asked you what it is you want to do with my dog Gizmo, and your response is that I just simply can't have it back. So it'll be on Thursday the 13th at 9 a.m. Salina, Ohio. It'll be above the police station in the municipal court building. Sandy Harrison and myself and counsel and other people will be there. So if anybody would like to come hear how this turns out, and keep in mind, Sandy, these are punishable crimes that you're doing. These are things that you can't lie and perjure yourself and make these claims without being held liable. You've now pushed it past the line where you could just walk away from this. You've now put your pen to paper and swore to a statement that is untrue. So we'll be seeing you the 13th at 9 a.m. to answer to the charges of aggravated menacing. And once again, Sandy Harrison, I still don't like you. I'm not going to like you after I get my dog back. And I honestly think that there's something wrong. I'd be a little more meaner right now, but you know, I'm to the point where I think that there might be more here than you just being grouchy. I mean, there might be something else wrong. Or I could go off and I could cuss and yell at you and tell you how stupid I think you are and all this other stuff. But it's to the point where I'm wondering if you may have an issue that needs to be addressed and someone has to step in. Like I said, family member, relative, or maybe clergy needs to address these issues, or your husband. But there's something going on here that's just not right. So anyone interested in this, I'm sure the newspaper, media, and attorneys will be there on the 13th, and we'll see you there. Thank you.